Welcome back, everyone, to Dive Bar Gamers. Today we're playing another One Commander game. It's going to be, Gibbering Hordes versus Gibbering Hordes.
Yeah, so a little fishy going on.
Yeah, a little fishy today. We'll do our best to kind of make sure we state which models are which, since they're both unpainted and from the same faction. Luckily, we are not using... You do have a painted model, yeah. Luckily, they are not the same model, so we both have unique lists entirely. So we'll go ahead and start with my list, then I'll show you his list, and we'll get started. So I brought the starter box. So I have a unit of Carcanoi here. I have the Storm Siren wielding the Tidal Scepter and Relics of Ancient Malifaux. I have Striped Skulkers, and then a Dotted Striped Skulker group. I'll go to the other side of the table.
So I have a Frenzy over here with Shark Tooth Necklaces and Relics of Ancient Malifaux. I have the Alpha Crawler with Overeager, Massive Arms, and Roiling Innards. I have a unit of Eurazi and a unit of Armored Loaks.
Yeah, right there.
Yeah, cool.
Alright. And one more thing, we're also playing Set Traps on the standard deployment. So starting with the first activation is me, and I'm going to activate my Carcanoi. They did an advance action. They performed three spawn the egg clutches, and they spawned all three, cheating it in twice. And then they moved up 7 inches, and you can see our fancy started here tokens, so you can see where they came from. I am not coordinating strike, and it's going to go to my opponent.
Alright, so the Frenzy activated and they took a focused effort order for reinforcement. Each of them then took the Relics of Ancient Malifaux action, the Healing Magic's action, off of their asset. Because all of them were within 3 inches of a... Because another fire team from their unit is within 3 inches of all of them, they each got a positive flip on that. So they each got it, cheating once, they shot and got the trigger off on all of them. So they put like 5 reinforcement tokens over here.
Yep.
One on the Eurazi that they ate at the start of their action to flip into glory so I could get my 2 tactics tokens. They took a reinforcement off of their focused effort. And then for their morale action they get from being a commander, they knocked out a nipping at their heels and sort of pushed up a bit everyone but him.
Cool. And that X is where the original Eurazi team was.
Yep.
My activation was pretty simple. Ant Clutch went, got an Inspired token, and then hatched, spending the Inspired token. Goes back to my opponent.
So the Alpha Crawler ate one of the other units of Eurazi to flip into glory and received the rush order. Because of his Overeager, he gets +2 to all his acting values, including his speed, making him effective speed 11. So he ran 22 inches through the woods, took a has flip, my opponent cheated. So I took 2 damage, discarding 2 of my reinforcement tokens to not take it. And then he kind of slammed himself into that unit there and killed one of the fire teams. He's over there now.
That's quite the impressive turn. He is very angry.
He's not happy.
Alright, on my activation, I activated Storm Siren. She gave me 3 tactics tokens, and she ate this clutch egg to go to glory, which immediately caused a strength 3 hit on the big boy, which I then spent 1 of my tactics tokens to make go off and deal 1 point of damage. She then did a focused effort, gained an inspired token, and used Relics of Malifaux to bring this team back. And had to spend the Inspired to do that. She then summoned this marker with... what's the action? Endless Rain. Putting into base contact with her and these guys. And that was her turn.
Alright, the Armored Welts activated, ate one of the Eurazi teams, and rushed. And went through the forest and did not take any damage from the flip.
And the one's over here. So I activated my unit of Striped Skulkers. They started here. The first thing they did was eat the other Striped Skulker and then took a rush order to move up to here. And only one of them's barely touching that dipole marker. By the way, all the landmines are dipole markers.
Yeah.
In case we forgot to tell you that. They are this size. And then the regular dipole markers are mine on this side.
Staring down the predator slurids, the spirits of death incarnate come from black waters to destroy him. The Yarazi summon their morale and their willpower, and they get a reinforcement token and don't move.
Cool. My next activation was the other striped skulkers. They were not in range of any eggs to eat them. So instead they took a rush order from here and moved up. It'll be my turn again since my opponent has no other units to activate. My last unit was the egg. Gained an inspired token, hatched, and just barely hatched. And that is the end of the turn. So I'll clean up. I don't think there's anything up to note. So we'll go ahead and jump into turn two.
So the frenzy activated and took an advance action. They moved up, knocked off their morale action to push the Yarazi. Then they crept up themselves a little bit and spread out a tiny bit. They launched a Relics of Ancient Malifaux to heal over here to bring some of those dead Yarazi back. And then they pumped like 3-4 more tokens into the Alpha Crawler.
Yeah, he's got fat stacks.
He's got fat stacks for days. Now they are going to coordinated strike into him.
Cool.
The Alpha Crawler took an advance, discarding a tactics token to ignore the free strikes. He moved over these non-Titan fire teams, and he took some swings at the Storm Star.
And he knocked off
Relics of Ancient Malifaux.
Yep, completely. Not bad. He also took one damage from the Typhoon marker. So after the Alpha Crawler's turn, I played Heavy Rains to summon a Tidepool marker here. And then I activated Storm Siren, who then noped out of this situation with the Alpha Crawler over to the new...
Right out of dodge.
To the new Tidepool marker. She then took Focused Effort for an Inspired action and summoned another Rain marker here. And then used her morale action in order to place an objective marker for set traps.
Getting them beeps.
Yep, and then she's gonna coordinated strike. So I coordinated striked into these, I'll remember these eventually. Striped Skulkers. Started here, they did they moved up. This one placed a set traps marker. And this one took a swing at the Yarazi and did nothing with it. And it goes back to my opponent.
The Armored Whelks advanced before they moved the one over there, placed a marker. Then they both moved, and this one placed a traps marker.
Cool. And the other one's underneath them.
He's standing on his trap.
Cool. The Carcanoi activated. They stood their ground and gained a reinforcement token through their order. One of them took a swing at the armored skulks and killed one of them. And the other one took a swing at the Alpha Crawler and missed. They got one more reinforcement token from that swing, and this team did nothing. It's a bunch of slackers. And it goes back to my opponent.
The Yarazi advanced to move around a little bit. One of them took a swing at the Storm Siren and missed, and the other one moved into champion range of one of the Frenzy.
You're forgetting. They activated on...
Oh, yeah, and like four of them died.
Yeah.
They just sort of flew around the tide pools and decided it looked nice in the water for some reason.
Yeah, they're doing duck stuff.
Yeah, duck stuff. They're duck bugs.
So I activated the Carcanoi. They took a advance action, and one guy swung here and did nothing. And because my opponent has no more models, I just went to go ahead and activated my Clutch Egg. He also took an advance action and swung at the Alpha Crawler, doing no damage. And that's the end of turn two. So, start of turn three, we actually scored this turn. Both of us scored 4 points. And my opponent will be starting the turn.
The frenzy advanced. Before they move, they put some ancient healing magic into the Urazi to bolster them up a bit. They moved, moved into position, got an attack off their morale action to defeat one of the Skulker squads, and then did a little bit more healing on the Armored Whelks and the Urazi again.
Yeah, Skulkers are right here. We forgot the thing.
The Urazi activated, ate one of their friends. Some of them died in tide pools, and they focused effort and kind of pushed away.
Yeah, this was a coordinated strike, right?
Yep.
The what was her name? The Storm Siren activated. She went ahead and used the Tidal Scepter to teleport all the way over here. After I placed that new tide pool marker, she then placed another objective marker here. Used a walk to get to here, and then attempted to do Siren's Call on the Frenzy, but failed. And I'm coordinating striking. So with my coordinated strike, the Karganoi activated. I gave them the advance order. Two of them moved up, and I had to spend a tactics token to leave Big Boy's melee range. Oh yeah, they also ate my last clutch egg. Nothing happened special. They took a bunch of swings at the Armored Whelks, as well as the Frenzy. And they got two models off the Armored Whelks and killed one of the Frenzy. It goes back to my opponent.
The Armored Whelks activated. The one activating in the Tide Pool died. So that unit moved up, took a mucus shot at the Karkanoian Mist, and I'm using my last tactics token to coordinated strike into the Alpha Crawler.
Da-da.
The Alpha Crawler walked to there to kind of cover that objective marker, took a swing on the Skulker there, obliterated the poor fellow, and then took a swing and missed on the Karkanoi.
Yep, and that kills the entire Striped Skulker unit. My last unit of Striped Skulkers moved up, placed one more objective marker here, and managed to kill one Urazi. That is the end of the turn, so we'll clean everything up, count up where we're at, and start turn four.
The Frenzy activated, healed up the Armored Whelks, did some pushing and moving, and placed out an objective marker.
Cool. And they're coordinated striking?
Yep, they are going to go into the Armored Whelks. Armored Whelks took an Inspire token, swung and missed against the Skulkers and the Urazi. Karkanoi.
Yep, and it goes to me. The Storm Siren activated, generated her tactics tokens. First thing she did was Siren's Call, the Alpha Crawler. We started here, ended up directly on top of this portal here. She then took a move action and used her free morale to place another objective. Now I'm coordinating striking into the Karkanoi. Karkanoi activated. I gave them the advance order. This guy moved up and took out the objective marker. Luckily, the trap marker took no damage. These two kind of pummeled the crap out of the Armored Whelks and did one damage. Goes back to my opponent.
Alpha Crawler gains a rush order. Lands two attacks, rips off the last asset.
Striped Skulkers activated, took an advance order, and killed off the... what did I?
Urazi.
As my opponent doesn't wear activations, it goes back to me, and I'll activate the other Striped Skulkers. The only thing he did was did a focused effort for a reinforcement token, took a swing, did nothing. And that's the end of the turn. We'll clean up, go into turn 5. Start of turn 5, we had one unit of this Striped Skulkers come back, and that is it. We're currently at 19 to 11.
Alpha Crawler receives an advance order, takes three swings at the Storm Siren, misses the first two, and fails to pen with the third.
The Striped Skulkers activated, did a focused effort in order to gain an Inspired token, took two swungs and missed both times. This is your activation.
No worries. Armor block, focused effort for inspire, take some swings and inevitably miss. One against the Arazi and one against Skulkers.
The Striped Skulkers activated. They took an advance action, made a couple attacks onto the, Arazi? Yeah. Yep, Arazi, and finished off the team that came back. They then moved with their advance action. The remaining two teams placed two objectives. Coordinated stroke into the Storm Siren, who took an advance action. First thing she did was Siren's Call the Alpha Crawler into the pool marker he's now standing on. She then walked 6 inches up to here, and her activation was done.
The Frenzy took an advance action. They riled themselves up, some movement, moved up and placed two objective markers. They took a couple swings off the morale action and killed one of the Carcanoi squads.
Yeah. My last unit, the Carcanoi, activated. They took an advance action. One guy took a swing at here, did no damage. Then the remaining team moved, discarding a tactics token to get out of engagement, then spent another tactics token to place an objective. And they're done. Alright, so we're at the end of the game now. It was 31-19 in favor of the Storm Siren crew. Any interesting thoughts?
Putting down objectives to score points wins you games.
Yep.
Yeah.
Key tip to the younglings.
Yeah, key tip. Because these are pro strats here. You put down more markers that score victory points than your opponent, you will win the game.
Yep.
I think legitimately the takeaway here is that, which has kind of been our trend, generating and managing your resources is what wins you games over your opponent.
Yes.
In this game, Kevin had a little bit of a stronger resource generation. I would say mine stretched farther, just the way that the Frenzy basically flipped two cards and everything there did. But that one tactics token and the way he used his resources is what gave him a decisive victory over the endless game.
Yeah, and I got really lucky with some card draws, too.
None of us got really lucky with our fate hands, but...
No, not really. But it doesn't matter. Like, half of our units were flipping two cards anyways.
Right, yeah. If it would have been nice if the Alpha Crawler had flipped one good card past turn three, but that still would have only been a... It probably still would have been at least a 7-point swing in your favor.
Yeah, he's still a wrecking ball. I mean, he still has how many reinforcements on him?
Three, and that's after I kind of stopped paying attention.
Yeah, I stripped at least three at some point.
Yeah.
There's no way he was going down this turn.
Nope.
Or this game.
Yeah, I don't know if he's the best investment at one commander, but 11 reinforcement tokens out of 10 would take a go.
Yeah, I mean, if you only have to pay for him with 7 tokens, for instance, because you don't really care about upgrades, because I don't think I even got near the upgrades in terms of damage.
Nope.
It's not a bad investment. Yeah. I don't know. Fishies are pretty fun.
Yeah, fishies are pretty fun. There's more fishies.
Yeah, we'll definitely be seeing more in future games, I'm sure. Either you or I will be playing more. And eventually they'll get more painted, too. Alright, well, until next time, like, favorite, subscribe, follow us, tweet back.
Yeah, we do the tweets now.
We'll throw in a link. There's nothing really exciting in there. You don't have to follow.
No, please don't. The more that people follow and interact with the tweets, the more I have to do the tweets.
Yeah. Tweet back.
I don't know.
We've been Dive Gamers. See ya.